So, you want to learn how to paint with watercolor, but you have no idea where to start. Well, I'm here to help you guys today. Hey everyone, my name is Emma LaFave and welcome to my channel. If you have not been here before, today is actually a great day to start because I am starting a three-part series on where to start with watercolor. I've done a few videos on this before, but I just wanted to update it and make sure that it's available to you guys. And yeah, for the first part of the video, I want to talk about supplies. Now, maybe you just want to start watercolor because you want to learn how to be creative this year, you want to reduce stress and anxiety, which watercolor is amazing for, or maybe you were given supplies at Christmas and you just have no idea how to use them. Either way, I've got you. So to start off, like I said, we're going to be talking about supplies. I'll be giving you some lower budget options as well as some great products that I think are also great for beginners. So let's just do it. Okay, so you walk into an art store, well, probably not nowadays. You go online at an art store or on Amazon and you're like, I don't know which watercolors to buy. There are just so many. Honestly, the first thing I'm gonna say is buy what is ever in your budget. If you've never painted with watercolors before and you're just like, wanna try them out, go for it. Go for the cheapest option. I started painting with an Artist Loft palette from Michaels that was about $7.99, and that is what kicked off my obsession with watercolor. You do not need the most expensive supplies to start, you just need to start. So you're gonna need watercolors, you're gonna need a brush, and you're gonna need some paper. So like I said, I got an Artist Loft palette. I think I got an Artist Loft pad of watercolor paper, which is not great, but I still used it. And I also had brushes from the dollar store. So really, any materials that you can find, use them just to start off with. See if you even like it. But now I'm gonna talk about some supplies that I actually really recommend. Now, like any new hobby, things cost money, right? You're not gonna find the cheapest of the cheap for everything. And the one thing with watercolor that does cost money and is important for quality is paper. Okay, so what I started off with the Artist Loft pad, and then I moved to Canson. They're not the greatest quality. Can you paint on them? 100%. Do I still use them sometimes? 100%. But it's not gonna give you the best results. When you're just starting out and you're wanting to learn how to do, like, you know, simple strokes, mixing colors, use cheap paper, okay? You're just learning how to kind of get your hand in that motion and become familiar with the medium. But if you start producing work and you're just like, it's not looking like your tutorials, I'm gonna tell you, it's probably not you, it's your paper. I definitely have a video on that, so if you want to check it out, make sure you click the link or look in the description below. I'll put it there too. Paper is probably the most important supply that you will need with watercolor. So some of my favorites are, I'm going to go and start with the cheapest option, which I believe, and these are Canadian dollars, so it might differ where you are. Some of these products also might not be available where you are, so just keep that in mind. I'm just going for what's available to me and that I have links for on Amazon. But I will also recommend some stores in the US and in Canada where you can find these supplies. So the first thing I'm going to recommend is these Paul Rubens watercolor sketchbooks. Now they're hot pressed. Now you might be like, what the heck's the difference between hot press and cold press? I keep seeing these things on the websites. Okay. Cold press has a bit more texture to their paper and it also absorbs water a lot better. Hot pressed is a lot smoother. It's greater for illustrations, but this paper is also 100% cotton. So if you're looking for high quality paper, you want to see 100% cotton. And a lot of watercolor papers don't have that. The ones that do have the greatest impact on how good your work is going to turn out. So the Paul Rubens sketchbooks, I think they retail for $22 on the Canadian Amazon website. I have links for the American one as well below. But I actually love this paper and it's because it's 100% cotton. So I use it for illustrations mostly, but it does take watercolor really, really well. It absorbs, you get really nice blends, which you'll find out later what all those things mean, but it's a pretty good start and it's in a little book, which is actually really handy. It's not the biggest paper, but it's affordable and it's really nice to use. The second paper I'm gonna recommend is B watercolor paper. So some things happened with this company where they were out of stock everywhere. I heard rumors about bankruptcy, but now everyone's saying they're back on Amazon. They're just more expensive. So I used to be able to get a pad of 25 sheets this size. This is like the rest of the B watercolor paper I had. And it was $20 at Michaels. and I used to get it with the 50% off coupon, and it was 10 bucks. And then I think on Amazon, it used to be cheaper. Now I believe you can get the same paper, but it's more expensive. Is it worth it? Yeah, it's great paper. It's 100% cotton. It's really great to work with. Will I be buying it again? Probably not, because I found better quality paper that I really love that's a bit more expensive, but in my mind, it's worth it. But if you are still looking for a better price point, this is probably a really good option. I do love their paper, but it's not my favorite, but it's awesome for beginners. My next favorite paper is probably my all-time favorite paper that I'm gonna suggest, and you probably see a lot of watercolor artists use it, is Etchr's cold press watercolor paper. It's not cheap, depending on where you get it. I found a little store in Richmond Hill, Ontario, where I used to live, and the guy was selling them for $16.99 a pad, and that was probably the cheapest I've ever found it. If you're interested in where that store is, if you're in that area, you can always DM me on Instagram and I will definitely let you know. But it's hard to find that price anywhere else. So they used to have it at Michael's. It's been out of stock in a lot of places. I don't know if it's back on Amazon, but this, if you can find this paper, I would definitely suggest it. It is super high quality, probably the best watercolor paper you can use, and it is amazing for your work. It's definitely an investment, but if you're gonna invest in any supply with watercolor, it should be paper and it should be this one. And then lastly, Etchr Lab cold press watercolor sketchbooks is also one of my favorites, but it is probably the most expensive. The great thing about these sketchbooks is you can keep all your artwork in one place. Also, it has 26 sheets that you can use front and back. Etchr's, I mean, you can use front and back, but I don't. One side is definitely way more textured and is better for painting than the other. In these, it is the same front and back. So you can get 26 sheets times two. They're pretty decently sized and it's amazing quality paper. It's 100% cotton. That's the thing that all four of these recommendations have in common. 100% cotton paper. Makes a huge difference, trust me. But like I said at the beginning, if you don't have the budget for it, don't do it. Start off with something cheaper, see if this is something you actually enjoy, then save up money for it or ask for it for next Christmas or your birthday, whatever. Just use what you have available to you. The next thing I'm gonna talk about are paints. So there's tons and tons of brands of paints out there. And a lot of people ask me why I tend to use the same brand. It's because paints can get expensive. And I also don't want to try a ton of different paints and then have to buy more. Like, a lot of them just sit there, right? I use my one palette and I'll keep filling that up. I don't want to sit with drawers full of paints that I'm not really going to use. So my favorite is Winsor & Newton. I have been using it since the beginning, except for that first Artist Loft palette. I went to a workshop and I was given 5 tubes of Winsor & Newton COTMAN watercolors. So the COTMAN watercolors look like this in tubes, and I like the tubes I've explained before because I find they last a lot longer. They also come in pans. So a pan set can look like this. This is a big pan set. You do not need a pan set this big. They have a lot smaller ones. I just have this big one. And I'll tell you right now, I don't use it that often. I like the tubes better. But you can get them in pans, whatever your preference is. I do have a video comparing the two, so I will also link that one below. I gotta remember all this. But these also tend to be a bit cheaper. So why do I use the tubes and how do I use them? Okay, so these are 8 milliliter tubes. And what I do is I put them into my palette. So I also have a palette that I got off Amazon. I believe this one was 10 bucks. You can get a smaller one for cheaper. I really like when they fold because I can take them places. But what I do is I squeeze the tube into the little wells and then I let them dry overnight. This way the paints last a lot longer. And I find, especially when you're a beginner, if you use them straight out of the tube, you're gonna use a lot more paint than you think you need. So letting them dry overnight is kind of key to making them last. So that's what I like to do. Again, other artists might do it completely different. That's totally okay. Use whatever works for you. But I highly suggest the COTMAN brand. These are student grade, so they're not as expensive as the professionals that I use now, but I used these for years and I only upgraded to professional watercolors. These are the professional ones. They're also smaller. I upgraded to these because someone was generous enough to give me them. And then I just started to build my collection off that. But start with these. I will also link the top 10 colors that I suggest for beginners. You do not need 20 colors. Like, I have a ton of colors in here. You do not need this many. I will tell you right now, do not feel like you have to buy this. You need maybe 5. I also have a video on how to mix a ton of colors with a limited palette, so I will also put that down below. And yeah, that's about it. I like the COTMAN brand. There are other brands out there that I haven't tried. I know some people like Arteza, that's American, that's fairly affordable. I wouldn't suggest anything like Reeves or Artist Loft. Keep in mind that the cheaper the paint, the more it's gonna crack in your palette. So if you do decide to put them in your palette and let them dry overnight, if they are a cheap tube paint, they will not last in there. So I know for a fact that Winsor & Newton COTMAN does last in there, and then the higher quality ones will as well. Otherwise, I'd suggest maybe getting a pan set. Okay, and lastly, brushes. So you may see that I use the same brushes in all my videos. I like these Princeton snap brushes. They are very affordable for where I am. And I like them because they're stiff. They have this really good snap. They're called Princeton snap brushes, and they have these stiff bristles that have a good snapback. And for me, I just find that's a lot easier to work with. I find some brushes can be a bit too soft. This is my preference, but brushes are totally an individual thing. Whatever your preference is, maybe you don't like a stiff bristle. Maybe you like something that's a bit softer. Just go with whatever feels good. Again, I used brushes from the dollar store for a while. They work. It's totally fine. But those are the ones that I suggest to use. If you are in Canada, they have them at Curry's Art Store or Deserre's for an affordable price. And if you're in the US, I know Dick Blick also has them for a very affordable price. And you can order those off of their website. So those are the ones I suggest, but definitely go with whatever feels good to you. Okay, so now you know all the supplies to buy, or maybe you have them and you're like, now where do I go from here? Do I just jump into a painting? No, I am going to be doing another video next week that is going to show you some drills to practice, the basic techniques of watercolor that are going to help you with your paintings. Now, if you can't wait, I do have videos of that already, but I am going to do another one kind of going over things I have gone in the past. So if you don't want to wait, definitely check them out. I'm gonna give you a little tip. If you're interested in anything that I've done before and you're not sure if I've done it, type it into YouTube. Type in my name, Emma LaFave, and then write water control, Emma LaFave supplies, Emma LaFave trees. Maybe you wanna learn how to paint trees. Emma LaFave Valentine's Day. And all of my videos that I've done on those topics with those keywords will pop up. So if you're interested, if I've done cat tutorials, or a dog portrait, or florals, just type in Emma LaFave and then the word, and they should all pop up right there. But next week, I will be going over those drills and techniques. Like I said, it's very important to learn them because watercolor is a totally different medium than, you know, the stuff we used to paint with as kids, like acrylic and tempera paint. It reacts totally different, and there's some really cool things that you can do with it. And the last thing I'm gonna talk about is what to expect with watercolor. Are you gonna be wonderful at it right away? Heck no, was I? Not a chance. But it's something that is meant to relax you and for you to enjoy. So if you're not enjoying it, don't feel like you have to keep up with it. Also, don't be so hard on yourself because you're not supposed to be perfect at anything right away. This is supposed to be more of an experience rather than an outcome. So just know that with tons and tons of practice, you will get to where you wanna go. But like anything, you just have to practice. And in the meantime, enjoy it because it's actually a lot of fun and I love it so much. And I used it as a way of therapy when I really needed it, when I was feeling down and anxious. So I really hope it does that for you too. So just remember to relax, do not be hard on yourself, and enjoy the process. If you guys have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Head on over to my Instagram and DM me there because I always answer my DMs on Instagram. And I think that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I really hope you liked it and I hope you learned something. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and follow me on Instagram for even more. Have a great day, guys. Bye.